In the wake of deteriorating India-China relations, not a day passes when the government of India does not take some measure to counter China. Like today, on September 2, India has banned 118 more Chinese apps. But folks, yesterday, that is September 1, a more important long-term policy initiative was unveiled for the first time to counter China and to take on China on issues like trade. Because we all know China is the world battery. And now more and more countries are coming forward to counter China's dominance of global trade and supply chains. In this backdrop, three major democracies have gathered together: India, Japan, and Australia. On September 1, their trade ministers held a first of its kind meeting, a virtual meeting through video conferencing because of COVID pandemic, to decide on a slew of measures to counter China in terms of global trade and supply chains. Now, I am Rajiv Sharma. Friends, let me give you the details. It's a very short video. Please see till the end. Now, what has happened is that on September 1, the three trade ministers, Piyush Goyal from India, Simon Birmingham from Australia, and Kajiyama Hiroshi from Japan, they had a brainstorming session. And a joint statement was released by the three countries. Let me read out this joint statement, the operative portion. Recognizing the pressing need for regional cooperation on supply chain resilience in the Indo-Pacific. Now, focus is Indo-Pacific, which is China's focus. Recognizing the pressing need for regional cooperation on supply chain resilience in the Indo-Pacific, the ministers shared their intention to work toward the launch of a new initiative to achieve the objective through cooperation. They instructed their officials to promptly work out the details of the new initiative for its launch later this year. They noted the important role of business and academia in realizing the objective. Now, India, Japan, and Australia have also invited the like-minded countries in the Indo-Pacific region to come forward. Now, obviously, New Zealand will be on board and many other countries will be on board, and this initiative is going to broaden further. More importantly, Piyush Goyal has described Australia, India, and Japan as crucial players in the Indo-Pacific region, and said that during 2019, he gave the 2019 figures, the cumulative GDP of the three countries was $9.3 trillion, which is quite a lot. And the cumulative merchandise, goods and services trade among the three countries, these figures were $2.7 trillion and almost $1 trillion respectively. So now the democracies, the world democracies, as the US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo had recently stated, had called upon the leading democracies of the world to come together to counter China. This is already happening, and China is going to face music in every sphere of life. Be tuned, and I will keep coming to you with such topics. Please subscribe to my channel, Rajiv Kishkinda. Thank you.